check your brakes. I'm gonna check my brakes. Let go. My brakes are good. Airplane. What?
0? 3-0.
Okay. Watch the tire on that side. Don't get stuck in the mud. Okay, he said 3-0 be off.
Down Paco. Stop here momentarily.
Why?
Check my map.
No, you don't do that. They said they asked you to go all the way to 3-0. You got to go all the way to 3-0.
Alpha Echo.
Alpha Echo. You could stop over there and do whatever you have to do. But once they give you a taxi clearance, you got to follow it all the way through.
Echo would be that way.
Yep. This is Alpha. That's Echo. See the E right there?
Yes, sir.
That's saying that's Echo. Turn here.
That's runway 30.
That's right.
My pad's over there. Over there.
Over where?
Over there. That's my pad, yes?
No. There's a whole shoreline. You're just gonna go to the whole shoreline. There's no pad here.
Okay.
So sometimes they ask you to go in there.
The Hawthorne?
That's a Hawthorne ramp.
Okay.
But here you just go up to the whole shoreline and do your run up right there, right on the whole shoreline. 30 doesn't have a pad.
Ready to stop. Full stop. Cabin doors and windows closed and latched, please. Thank you, sir. Flight controls, check movement. Down, up, down, up. Elevator, up, down, down. Elevators are working nicely. Elevator trim. Position. Throttle. Can you hear me okay?
Yep.
Suction's in 5. Oil's in the green. Oh, actually we have more fuel than I expected. I thought we only had 3/4. Okay, we have basically full on both wings. Magnetos. Right magneto. A little bit of a drop. A little bit of a drop. Carb heat. Drop. And meter check by splitting only the master. Wiggled. We're fine. Bottle retard to idle. Okie dokie. My flight instrument set for executive tower. We go. Start off confirmation. You hear me okay?
I can hear you.
Okay.
Why do you say that?
Because sometimes I can't hear myself. That concerns me. I keep cutting in and out. I don't like that. Okay. Landing lights on. Flaps are up. Correct. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Executive Tower, Cessna 6001 Golf, holding short of runway 30, ready for northeast departure.
600 Gulf Executive Tower, runway 30, line up and wait, traffic crossing downfield.
Runway 30, we'll be waiting, 01 Golf.
He said line up and wait.
We'll be line up and wait, runway 30, 01 Golf.
Okay, when
he said... Jack 9, you're from Delta Runway 34, taxi.
You're going to line up on the runway and wait.
Taxi B, Kilo, hold short to 341 for 94 Delta. And that we'll be holding short of 241 for 94 Delta.
Skyhawk 01 Gulf, right turn to the northeast. Runway, actually for now, make it a right turn to the north, runway 30, cleared for takeoff.
01 Gulf, runway 30, cleared for takeoff.
Right turn to the north.
Right turn to the north. We can go.
They gave you permission?
Yes. Yes, sir. Line up.
Okay.
I'm ready to go.
Go, don't wait. There's another guy waiting for you.
That's Skyhawk 65 Tango. Traffic's on the roll, runway 30, runway 34, clear to land, wind calm.
There's another guy landing.
Traffic in sight, 34, clear to land, set to go.
Stay in the center, don't wiggle and wobbly. Got the airspeed.
As soon as I hit 1100, I'm turning to the northeast.
No, he said north.
North.
He has somebody out there in the northeast that he doesn't want you to go into. So he said, for now, turn to the north.
Holding short of runway 34.
Okay, did you hear that?
Skyhawk 01 Golf, you can turn right to the northeast now.
01 Golf, northeast.
Now you can go, but no, you haven't reached your altitude yet. So reach your altitude first and then go up to the northeast. A little bit higher like that, a little bit steeper. Get yourself up there. Alright, you're about 1,000, close to 1,000 feet now. You can start your turn now, slowly.
Skyhawk 7 Juliet off Executive Tower, Roger, be just a moment. Skyhawk 65 Tango, is it Area 2?
Affirmative.
Skyhawk 65 Tango, taxi via Kilo Tree and Kilo Echo, cross runway 24,
Bravo,
Bravo,
Bravo. Kilo Echo Bravo to Area 2, cross 2465 Tango with you.
Straight north?
Northeast, he said. He cleared you for the northeast departure.
Skyhawk 7 Juliet Alpha, left or right traffic, your choice, runway 34, cleared for takeoff.
I'd like to request right traffic, cleared for takeoff, 87 Juliet Alpha, 34.
Skyhawk 7 Juliet Alpha, roger, make right traffic.
What altitude do you want me at?
Skyhawk 01 Gulf, not receiving the transponder.
You didn't put your transponder on. We'll recycle the transponder, 01 Golf. Don't ever admit that you forgot the transponder, because that's a violation. Okay? You gotta say, I'll recycle it. Recycling means shutting it down, turning it back on.
We're okay?
Yeah, now he's gonna say, he's gonna receive, he'll say, I got your transponder. But if you forget, just say, I'll recycle it. I'll recycle my transponder, 01 Golf.
I didn't turn it all the way off.
You didn't turn it on. You didn't turn it to ALT.
Okay.
And that's a requirement. That's required under class
problem. Skyhawk 7 Juliet Alpha, receiving the transponder now. Altitude indicates 1,600.
I should call him back?
No, that's not us.
Okay.
Is that for 01 Golf?
That was. I'm sorry, Skyhawk 01 Golf. Receiving the transponder now. Altitude indicates 1,700.
Affirmative, 01 Golf.
And tower.com 4112 is with you 6.5 mile final for 16. Any chance we can land at 16?
Dotcom 4112 Executive Tower, unable. I've got a pattern to runway 34, so a report canceling IFR to circle west of the field, left traffic, runway 34.
Okay, west of the field, traffic to 34, Dotcom 4112.
It is kind of hazy. It's actually
negative Tower. I'll
say 5 miles.
Delta, ready to use for takeoff.
Did I say
7? 7, 7, said 7.
Skyhawk 149, Uniform Delta, Executive Tower, right traffic, runway 34, clear for takeoff. Traffic to Challenger, 6F, not correction, 5 miles north for the left island, runway 34.
Visibility 9 miles based on the Ada Sierra.
Make right traffic, 149, Uniform Delta.
Dotcom 41, traffic Skyhawk departing runway 34, and he'll be making right traffic.
Okay, and we'll start to swing west. We can cancel at this time on Dotcom
41. Based on Ada Sierra, visibility was 9 miles.
You see that Kokona over there?
Yes, yes, sir, I see it.
Fly right over it. They're heading like a little bit more east here. Northeast is like somewhere that way.
You know what that cocoon is?
Yeah, that's a golf range.
Oh, how nice.
That's, the area's had a park. Once you pass that cocoon, you're outside of the airspace. You're outside of Delta.
Sac 7 Juliet Alpha, can you make sure to approach?
Affirmative.
Sac 7 Juliet Alpha, make sure to approach. There's a Challenger on the left island to follow you. Runway 34, clear to land.
Runway 34, clear to land. 87 Juliet Alpha.
Dotcom 4112, your number 2 following the Skyhawk on the right base.
Dotcom 4112.
Hey, Executive Tower, Dakota 2955 Tango is ready at 3-4.
Dakota 2955 Tango, Executive Tower, roger. Hold short runway 3-4, it'll be a moment.
55 Tango, holding short of 3-4.
Okay, you're outside of the Delta, right? You're right here by the cocoon?
Yes.
Well, now you can start tuning into to the ATIS.
132.40. Yep. Mission Whiskey. Well, keep guitar information Whiskey, time 1255.
Is it Great Lakes over there? The fuel that sticks out?
Yes. 7, sky clear. Temperature 18, 2.15. Altimeter 2980. Expect a visual approach. Landing runway 23. Read back hold short instructions and runway assignment. Advise initial contact. You have information Whiskey. Corky Guitar Information Whiskey, time 1255 Zulu weather, wind 3006, visibility 7, sky clear. Temperature 18, 2.15, altimeter 2980. Expect a visual approach. Landing runway 23. Read back hold short instructions and runway assignment. Advise initial contact. You have information Whiskey. Corky Guitar Information Whiskey, time 1255 Zulu weather, wind 3006, visibility 7, sky clear. Temperature 18, 2.15, altimeter 2980. Expect a visual approach.
Okay, give me slow flight.
Yes, sir, one moment, please. Slow flight has dropped the heartbeat on. Reduced to 1700.
Yeah, but why are you diving? Look at you're diving into the ocean. You have to maintain that altitude. Maintain the altitude, that's the whole thing about slow flight. And keep your wings level, you'll stall the plane if you don't keep them level. First of all, you had to do a clearing turn. Come back up to 2500. You want to maintain that altitude. Do a little clearing turn out there, right? This is a maneuver, so you have to, for every maneuver, you got to do a clearing turn. They're changing the ATIS. No, they're changing it. There's a void there because they're going to give you a new one.
Waukegan Tower, information X-ray, 1355 Zulu weather, wind 280 at 6, visibility 8, sky condition clear, temperature 19er, dew point 16, altimeter 29er 81, visual runway 23 approach in use. Read back, hold short instructions,
okay,
and runway alignment. Advise on initial contact, you have information X-ray.
And we'll just do 190 here, 190 to the north, and then you give me slow flight. You see that little steeple right there?
Yes.
That's the midway point between Executive and Waukegan.
Clear. Temperature 19er, dew point 16, altimeter 29er 81. Visual runway 23 approach in use. Read back, hold short instructions and runway assignment. Advise on initial contact, you have information X-ray.
Okay, this is good right here.
Waukegan Tower, information X-ray, 1355 Zulu weather.
Now remember, it's maintaining the altitude.
Visibility 8, sky condition clear.
All the way down.
2.16.
All the way.
Perimeter.
Get it down. No, the other way. Down.
Visual runway 23 approach in use.
Right there.
Short instructions and runway assignment.
All right, so you're maintaining the altitude here.
You have information X-ray.
Pitch down just a little bit. See, it's hard to see the horizon. That's that's why you don't want to do stalls in a day like today, because
information
don't have a reference. But,
1355.
Okay, you're maintaining the altitude.
280 at 6.
Add a little power.
Visibility.
Maintain that.
Sky condition clear. Temperature 19er, dew point 16, altitude.
And just you're trying to keep the wings level, right?
Yes, sir.
Runway 23.
That's the main thing here. Give me 10 degrees of flaps.
Hold short instructions and runway assignment. Advise on initial contact, you have information.
It's going to want to pitch up, so watch, keep an eye on that.
Waukegan Tower, information.
Okay, give me a turn to the left.
1355.
Slowly, very slowly.
Wind 280 at 6.
Very slowly, you do your turns.
Sky condition clear. Temperature 1.
So you could be turning this way and the controller facing the other way.
1.
Okay, give me a turn to the right.
Approach in use.
Slowly, very slowly.
Short instructions and runway.
Okay, you're maintaining the altitude, that's good.
Contact, you have information X-ray.
That nose down just a little bit.
Waukegan Tower, information.
Okay, we're coming up to the pier. You see the piers there?
Yes.
That's the 7 miles. That's where I want you to call them. So let's recover.
Clear.
Vibrator key comes in, full power.
Altimeter.
And then you're going to bring up your flaps.
Full runway 23 approach in use. Read back, hold short instructions and runway.
About 70, right? You got 70, bring up your flaps. You got them up already? All right. Okay. All right, so get ready to give him a call. You got X-ray, right?
Information X-ray, 1355 Zulu weather, wind 280.
And you can bring the power back to cruise.
Visibility 8, sky condition clear. Temperature 19er, dew point 16, altimeter 29er 81. Visual runway 23 approach.
Give him a call.
Read back, hold short instructions and runway assignment. Advise on initial contact, you have information X-ray.
I'm going to tell them Waukegan Tower, Cessna 6001 Golf, approaching to land on runway 24.
Now you say, you'll say Waukegan Tower, Cessna 6001 Golf, 7 miles southeast, inbound for landing, with information X-ray.
Waukegan Tower, Cessna 6001 Golf, southeast 7 miles, inbound for landing with ATIS X-ray.
6001 Golf, King Tower, ready to report left base, runway 23.
01 Golf, left base, runway 23.
Okay. Got the airport in sight? Yep, that's it. All right, add a little power, that's going to sit there. 4400 is good.
I don't like our visibility.
Huh?
I don't like our visibility.
It could be worse.
It's about 7 miles though, isn't it?
It's about seven, the sun clear up a little bit. I would say 5 to 7 miles.
I am not familiar with Waukegan Airport. I'm sorry, left approach, okay. So I'm gonna go base that way, downwind, base, and then land 230.
What do you say?
Runway 23.
Yeah, but what, report what?
Left.
Left base for 23?
Yes.
Okay. 23 is facing this way.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So a base would be like that, right?
Yes.
And then a final would be like this.
I'm going to be coming down that way.
So you're going to be going this way, and then base, and then final.
Okay.
You see those stacks right there?
Yes.
Okay, fly this right at the edge here. Fly this.
Then
we're going to go straight into a base, and then a final. The runway faces this way. You see it? The long runway there.
He
doesn't want you to go into the pattern. He wants you to go base to final. We're almost set up on base. He said a 3 mile base, right? Is something in?
Can I call him and confirm?
We'll give him a heads up at 3 miles. Right now we're coming up on 5 miles. 4 miles is a tower. Those
stacks. We're gonna go parallel that way?
No, we're not gonna do the downwind. He didn't say enter the pattern.
Okay.
He said report a 3 mile left base for runway 23.
Which means we're gonna end up landing that way?
No, we're gonna be going base this way, and then we're gonna be landing this way.
On the long way?
Yep.
On the long runway?
Yes. So that's the runway going this way.
All right.
We are over here. We're going to go like this and like that.
Okay. I think I should call him, yes?
Not yet. You're not even 4 miles yet. 4 miles is the stacks here. So you can start coming down to your pattern altitude. Once you pass those stacks, start descending to your pattern altitude. Your pattern altitude here is 1500. The stacks?
On your left or the right?
They're right below. You're gonna descend right on top of them. But don't descend yet. But you see them. You don't want to descend on top of them, right? See them over here?
Yes, I see them.
Okay.
We are going to land, right? Not touch and go?
We'll request touch and goes.
We'll request touch and goes.
When he gets back to you, tell him requesting touch and goes.
Can I call in?
I did. Okay, now you call him up, tell him, Waukegan Tower, 01 Golf, reporting 3 mile left base for 23.
Waukegan Tower, Cessna 6001 Golf, 3 miles base for runway 23, 01 Golf.
Cessna 01 Golf, runway 23, clear to land.
01 Golf, clear to land.
Alright, go like right towards that tower, you see that bubble tower?
Yes.
Town tower? And Waukegan Tower, 01 Golf, like to do some touch and goes.
Officer
touch and go and right traffic and departure, 01 Golf.
Carp heat is in.
Don't descend yet. Get a little closer.
Tower flight check 69 is holding short 23. Ready.
Flight check 69, King Tower. Can you take an immediate?
Yes, sir.
Flight check 69, runway 23, no delay. Traffic low at base. Cessna. Runway 23, turn left heading 140, clear to take off.
Somebody's
left 140, clear to go. Flight check 69.
Someone's going to take off.
Yep.
So do I go in pattern?
No. Don't worry. You got clear for landing. Don't worry about him. Got plenty of time.
Laps?
I would wait just a little bit. Wait till you're over that, what is that tower? A little closer. As a matter of fact, we're going to make this a no-flap landing.
No flaps?
No-flap landing. Gonna be a little shallower than normal.
I'm at about 1250 feet. Reducing power to 1700. Not yet.
Flight 69, contact Chicago approach, good day.
Lining it up. Reducing power. 1700, no flaps.
Have you ever landed no flaps?
Yes, sir, last time. Reducing power, getting ready to get rid of all the power. I will need assistance, I believe. Power's gone. Up, nose up a little bit. Nose is up a little bit.
Coming down just a little bit. Just want to fly 1 foot over the runway, just like this. Just like that.
Power on?
No. Why would you want power on? You haven't touched down yet. All right, carburetor heat goes in. Now power goes on. Okay, you got your airspeed, so pull up.
I have to inform him of my intentions?
No. So you're on the go, right traffic. Nose up a little bit.
What pattern altitude do I go to?
1500.
Tower, Cessna 5232 kilos, just off of Kenosha, VFR landing with X-ray.
Cessna 5232 kilo, King Tower, ready to report 4 miles north for right base, runway 23.
It's pattern altitude.
Here, we'll check 4 north for right base, 23.
There's another guy gonna come in right behind us. So he's out there in Kenosha. Kenosha's like 6 or 7 miles out. And he's gonna be entering a right base.
I'll make my turn.
Yep. What's this turn called?
Upwind.
Upwind is that going up to
base?
This right here is a right crosswind.
Right crosswind.
All right, look at the runway. Lift that wing up and look at that runway. Okay, you see it?
Yes.
Okay, you're a quarter mile now. Turn your downwind down. You're constantly looking at every phase. You're looking at the runway. You're leveling the wings and looking at the runway. You don't want to ever keep the runway off of your sight.
I'll get a chance to land before that guy, or touch and go before that guy comes in.
Yep. Yeah, it looks like it's cloudy or hazier out there. There's like a little layer of dark clouds out there.
Now we're downwind.
Angle a little bit more this way. You don't want to get too close. A little bit this way. Wind is pushing you towards the runway. You got to anticipate that. Winds are actually coming from that direction.
Park heat is on.
01 Golf, runway 23, clear, touch and go.
01 Golf, runway 23, touch and go. Beam the numbers. Waiting for the 45 to make the base.
What do you do now? Beam the numbers.
10 degrees.
Power reduces 1700. 10 degrees of flaps, right? Runway in sight. Okay, you're high, so you don't need power. Get the power out, 1700. Look how high you are. You're really squirrely here. You're off-centered. You know what happened? Why this happened? Because you were too close to the runway.
I gotta do a go-around.
You're too close now. You can make it. Take the power out. Get centered. Dump all the flaps. Yeah, dump the flaps. Get them all down. You get yourself down quick. Okay?
Nose up.
No. You get down to the runway first. 1 foot off the runway. You see? I'm a foot off the runway before I got any nose up. Okay? Now you get nose up. See that? Where he goes in, flaps come up, full power. Now, the reason this happened is because you were too close on downwind to the runway. You paralleled it too close, okay? And then you cut in, there was no base. You just went around like that. You overshot the final and all that. So go out a little bit more. A quarter mile is the end of that runway that intersects?
Yes.
The other side, the end of that runway is a quarter mile.
50 kilo, runway 23, clear to land.
Three, 2 kilos.
Look back at the runway. Could you turn your neck around this way?
Yes.
This way. Look at your runway.
23, clear to land.
You see it?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, you got the 1100?
Yes.
I want this like a square, like a box, okay? Like it's a rectangle box. Looking at the runway, you see that? Now you see, you can't see the end of the other runway, but I know that it's right about, keep it straight. About right here, this is where the other end of the runway is. This is how far I want to be. See that baseball diamond?
Golf number 2, follow Cessna, short final.
See that? There's the end of the other runway, you see it?
Yes.
That's where you want to be. This is how far you want to be. And that last one, we were like half of this distance.
Runway 23, clear for the option.
01 Golf, runway 23, clear for the option.
All right, stay parallel. Stay on this side, a little bit more to your left. You don't want it. You know what's happening here is the wind's pushing you. Winds are coming from that direction. They're pushing you into the runway. So you got to crab a little bit to the left. Okay, you got 1500. Looks better. Go out a little bit further out.
I have my car peed on.
Alright, and what else you got to get?
So 320 will turn left next, contact ground.
You got to get down to 17
first. 32 kilos.
So you bring some flaps on. Now you put the flaps. Alright. Look at the 45. 45.
Not yet. Not yet. Not yet.
Get that nose down. Don't ever put it above the horizon here.
Out now.
Alright. Don't add too much power. You're gonna stay too high. Keep the base coming. This is the base. It's a box, remember. This is your base right here. 10 degrees of flaps on base. Okay. Now, your final. See, this is more squared out. This is the way it should be. Alright, right here you're going to judge. You need flaps, you don't need flaps. I say you need flaps because you're high, right? I would dump them all. If you slow down too much, you have the option of adding power, right? Add a little power, just bump it in just a little bit. You don't have to add too much to get there. You're there. You made the runway. So, let's bring it out slowly. Come down to the runway. And then fly right over it. A little bit too high.
1 foot, 1 foot, 1 foot.
That nose up a little bit. Don't let that nose come down too fast. Down the center line. Alright.
RPD in. Flaps up. Power. I'm assuming this is it.
What?
Touch and goes.
Well, you're upwards down already, or what?
Yeah, I'm not asking you for what we're going to do.
I thought we were going to do another one.
Okay. We're getting wind from here. I got to crab into the wind a little bit.
That's the idea. Throughout the whole thing, you got to compensate for the wind. The whole pattern. You have to know where the wind's pushing you and stuff like that, so you gotta crab into the wind. On upwind, downwind, base, and final. Lift the wing up, look at the runway, okay.
Golf, please repeat.
01 Golf, runway 23, clear, touch and go.
01 Golf, runway 23, touch and go.
sun yet. It's not in the numbers yet. Grab a little bit to the left of the crosswind. It's going to push it into the runway. A little bit. See how it's pushing you? You're actually flying this way. You're flying like sideways. So you got to compensate for that. Don't be so jerky with the power. Leave it at 17. Turn your base. Look at that runway, okay? Okay, 10 degrees of flaps. 10 degrees of flaps on base. Alright, now you got final. Remember, it's gonna want to push you out. Out of center line. Stuff in there. Whoa, easy. Oh, horse.
I have the runway. Killing power. Holding, 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 gentle.
Come down a little bit more. Come down.
I'm coming. Gravity.
Come down to the runway.
Oh.
There. You heard that stall horn?
I did. I love that stall horn.
That's what you have to hear right before you touch down. All right. Get yourself
lined up.
And
carbine's in. Flaps are up.
Yep. You could do all that. You could bring your carbine in, flaps up, and while you're lining up. Okay. Parking entire system 01 Gulf, like a departure to the south.
One Golf, requesting departure to the south.
Wait, you got a position.
01 Golf.
Yeah, you got to be patient. Okay.
Beacon Tower, 4 Charlie Victor, Alpha 8, ready for takeoff 2-3. Here, 4 Charlie Victor, Beacon Tower, rudder standby. I got team crew needs to do real quick at the intersection of 1-4-2-3.
No problem. 4 Charlie Victor standing by, Alpha 8.
Runway 23, right close to that. Charlie Victor.
What's wrong?
Keep it climbing.
I am. Full throttle.
Alright, you got your 1100. There's a head south.
How you doing, JP? Hey, Rick, how you guys doing?
Good.
There's good America right there.
Yes, sir. I see the roller coaster.
After your position, change frequencies whenever you're ready. Have a good day.
What do I do?
Hey, frequency change approved. Have a good day, 01 Golf.
Frequency change approved. Thank you, 01 Golf. Is that okay?
Yep.
I don't understand. Oh, he says we're basically out of the range.
Yeah, he says no traffic. He didn't say you're out of the range, okay? You're still inside the range until you cross Great America there?
Yes.
It's like a circle, right? So it's out there. You're still within his airspace. But he gave you permission to change your frequency if you want to.
Okay.
So he said frequency change approved. Have a good day.
Okay.
So all you gotta do is say frequency change approved.
Thank you.
So now you could get your ATIS for executive, and you could tune whatever frequency you want. You could turn them off if you want.
Chicago Executive Airport Information Tango.
And he said, he also said, no observed traffic south of your position, so he's giving you advisory also, so there's nobody out there.
2.15, altimeter 2983, ILS runway 16 approaches in use, landing and departing runway 34 and 30. IFR arrivals, unable to cancel IFR to circle, advise
you to now, another thing, he could, you could request a frequency change also within the airspace. You could say requesting frequency change. They could approve it or deny it, and executive, they'll deny it because they have all this traffic coming in, and they don't want, they want to keep in contact with you. So it all depends, you know, how busy they are. Now, why would you do a frequency change? Maybe you want to call flight service or open your flight plan or something else.
1,700, temperature 20, 2.15, altimeter 2983, ILS runway 16 approaches in use, landing and departing runway 34 and 30. IFR arrivals, unable to cancel IFR to circle, advise Chicago approaching initial contact. Notice to airmen, runway 624 is closed. Vehicles and personnel, close but clear of taxiways and runways, use caution. Hazardous weather information for Illinois and surrounding areas available on high watch, flight watch, or flight service frequencies. Advise you have information Tango on initial contact. Chicago Executive Airport information Tango, 1352 Zulu, wind 330 at 4.
We'll stay right here, we'll stay at
2200. Few clouds, 1700. Temperature 20, 2.15. Altimeter 2983. ILS runway 16 approaches in use. Landing and departing runway 34 and 30. IFR arrivals unable to cancel IFR to circle. Advise Chicago approaching initial contact. Notice to airmen, runway 624 is closed. Vehicles and personnel close but clear of taxiways and runways. Use caution. Hazardous weather information for runway and surrounding areas available
to high
watch, flight watch, or flight service frequencies.
It's what?
Advise you have information
Abbott Labs.
On initial contact.
Have you heard of Abbott Labs?
Oh, Abbott Labs, yeah.
Chicago Executive Airport information Tango, 1352 Zulu, wind 330 at 4, visibility 10, few clouds 1,700, temperature 20, 2.15, altimeter 2983, ILS runway 16 approaches in use, landing and departing runway 34 and 30, IFR arrivals unable to...
I'm trying to find some kind of a landmark so I can know when to call them in.
What?
And personnel.
I'm not seeing anything. I don't want to get into their airspace and get them pissed off.
Please use caution.
That's it.
Hazardous weather information for Illinois and surrounding areas available on high watch, flight watch, or...
You see the expressway here?
Yes.
That's 294.
Yes.
So you know it follows. If you follow 294, you're going to get it.
Chicago Executive
Eventually, you'll see the airport to your right side, right?
Yes.
I can see the airport from here.
View clouds 1,700. Temperature 20.
I do not.
If you look out there,
yes,
you'll see like a white...
Buildings.
No, it's like a white patch.
IFR
see that? Way out there.
Circle by Chicago approach.
Over there?
Yeah, you see the expressway going out that way?
Yes, and there's a white patch there.
And there's a white patch on the right side?
Right, but I want to get in with the airspace and not have them know that I know.
All right, so this is the way you do it. Here. There's a landmark.
Well,
it's pretty difficult to see, but not from this angle.
Initial contact.
But, okay, you see the toll road right there? That's the toll road, that's the oasis.
Okay.
You see that?
Okay.
So that right there is a half-day road. So at half-day road, you're 10 miles from the airport.
2.15.
We're 10 miles right here.
2983. ILS runway 16 approaches in use. Landing and departing runway.
See the oasis?
Zero.
Yes.
Okay.
Arrivals unable to cancel IFR to circle.
So should I tell them?
Initial contact.
They're 10 miles, yeah.
10 miles north.
North. Say northeast.
Northeast.
Yeah.
Vehicles and...
There's something going on there. Somebody might got stuck. But what could you do if something like this goes on?
I could change to executive ground.
No, you could do 360. Do a 360.
Do a 360?
Yeah, look how high you are. You're supposed to be at 2,200 feet. You got all the power. Look at all your power. You're still climbing. That's why you never want to cruise. Do a 360. Somebody's mic is stuck. But let's see what happens.
beg pardon?
Southeast Tees.
There's 9 Whiskey Mike, Kilo 2, Kilo Northeast Tees, maintenance frequency.
Kilo 2 to Kilo to Northeast Tees with you. 9 Whiskey Mike.
Okay, so that is still able to connect.
Cessna 72 Alpha, runway 34, clear for takeoff.
Runway 34, clear for takeoff, 87 Juliet Alpha.
If you don't know where you're at for any reason, what you want to do is just climb up and do 360 so you get out of your bearings right, okay? So you know where you're at. Now, straight out there, that's Hawthorne Mall. You see, out there past the green?
Yes.
That's the mall, that's Hawthorne.
Okay.
So, and then we have a VOR just south of there. Okay, so you're going this way, right? Do your 360. Tell them you're 10 miles northeast and inbound for landing with the information.
Executive Tower, Cessna 6001 Golf, 10 miles northeast inbound for landing with ATIS Tango.
Cessna 6001 Golf, Executive Tower, another right down, runway 34.
Runway 3401 Golf.
Right downward.
Right downward. God, that is annoying.
Okay, get yourself back up to cruise.
I am at cruise.
No, you're not. You're 2200. Cruise is 2324.
Oh, you mean
RPMs.
RPMs. There's the airport right there.
Right.
We're almost there. And he cleared me with runway 34. So I'm going to go right base that way, way.
He said right traffic, so you're going to be making right turns.
Right.
Yeah, so you're going to go straight down this way, then you're going to make a right base and a final.
I got to descend.
Yeah, you've got to get closer. You're still far away. You're still 5 miles out. Or actually, you're 7 miles out. The VOR is right over there. That's 7 miles. So you're like 6 miles out right now. Okay? You see the Wesson Hotel?
I see the black buildings, the red, and the white.
Yeah, that's 2 miles from the airport.
Once I pass that, I'm going to make my base. I mean, my crosswind. Crosswind, my downwind, my base, and then I'm landing. Do you concur?
No.
No, you do not concur.
No, you're right here. You're on a 45 for a downwind. And then downwind, base, and then final.
Runway 34, clear to land, 87 Juliet Alpha.
What you gotta do is get down to your pattern altitude right here. What's the pattern altitude?
1800 feet.
1600. Right like this. Towards the one. Towards that. Right. There you go. Like towards the tower. Landing this way, 3-4, right?
Alright, yes sir.
Why are you going to cut on this way? 3-4 is at the other end,
yes,
on this way.
Yes sir.
It's the same thing as the pattern they walk in. You're going to go down one, and then turn base, and then final this way. Alright, maintain that altitude. Now when you're seeing the numbers, you reduce the power.
3238 Delta's 10 West Landing Tango.
West Gong, say again.
3238 Delta 10 West landing Tango.
3238 Delta enter left base 734.
Left base 3437.
Tell them you're downwind, sir, runway 34.
Executive Tower, Cessna 6001 Golf, downwind for runway 34.
301 Golf, runway 34, clear to land.
01 Golf, 34, runway 34, clear to land.
Cessna 7 Alpha, Kilo 3, Kilo, cross runway 2430, maintenance frequency.
Kilo 3, Kilo, cross runway 2430 to runway 3487 Juliet Alpha.
Hey, stop this. Our power first. Reduce the power before you reduce the stack. Okay. Turn the base. Don't ever bring the nose up above the horizon. Keep that nose down. Keep it squared. Square it out. Square, like one big square. Okay, there's a square. Right? The power is too low. 1700, right there. It won't make it. We got too little power.
I'm gonna turn into land.
No, not yet. How are you gonna turn in right now? You're not even fixing. Not even close to it. Alright, now you're set to turn. Left crosswind, okay? So you're gonna have to wing down on this side, and right rudder. Right rudder. Just like that. Not too much. Very little right rudder. Not too much.
Skywagon 3 Delta, runway 34, clear to land.
Land, plan Lima 2, 3 Delta.
Down mute.
You're off on the next one. Kilo 4.
Malibu 37 Victor Mike, ready for departure.
Malibu 37 Victor Mike, Executive Sir Roger, it's gonna be a couple minutes.
Roger.
Cessna 01 Golf,
A3.
Area 23.
A23, 01 Golf, that way?
Yeah. Cessna 01 Golf, Kilo 3, Kilo Echo Bravo, cross runway 24, remain this frequency.
01 Golf, Kilo 3, remain on this frequency.
Cross 24.
Cross 24.
Tower, here's 347 Charlie Papa, ready for IFR departure, 1-3-4 pad.
I've been given permission.
Here's
347
Charlie Papa,
taxi to
hold short
and
wait
34.
Taxi to hold short and wait
34. That's a Kilo 3, cross 24, right? 24 is over there.
Executive Tower, 87 Juliet Alpha, holding short of runway 34, ready to take off.
Roger.
Executive Tower, speech to 790, share with the RLS 16.
Falcon 790 Sierra Sierra Executive Tower 4 cancellation by IFR flight is circling for runway 34. Sooner the better on the cancellation.
Train up over there. Okay, say that again slowly,
right.
Sir.
Go say it, done.
Beachhead 0 Sierra Sierra 4 cancellation by IFR flight is circling to runway 34. Sooner the better on the cancellation so I can get some releases.
Okay, we'll do.
Yeah, Echo.
Bravo.
Yeah.
No, cross 2-4.
Cross 2-4.
I see nothing on 2-4.
Close. Got a big X on it? See that?
Yes, I see the big X. I see the big X.
Cessna 7 Juliet Alpha, runway 3-4, line of way, beach jet, 5 miles north inbound.
Lining up.
Be Zero Sierra Sierra, Cessna's holding in position.
Okay, Sierra Sierra, we can cancel at this time, sir, and you want us to circle right, correct?
Beachhead Zero Sierra Sierra, circle east or west of your choice. Let me know when you break off the approach and squawk VFR.
Breaking off at this time, sir.
Issue, Skyway 38 Delta, Lima 2, Lima to Motorola, remain this frequency.
Good with you, Lima 2, good morning.
Cessna 7, Jet Alpha, fly straight out, and you'll follow a beach jet off your left. Let me know when you get him in sight. Runway 34, clear for takeoff.
Runway 34, clear for takeoff. We'll take off straight out. We'll keep an eye out for traffic. 87, Jet Alpha.
Is annoying as hell.
I wonder, it has to be some other plane that's causing it. I wonder if it's us.
How? How?
I don't know.
Beachhead Zero Sierra.
Anything could be.
Sierra Sierra, thanks for that.
Set it down, turn back on.
I got it. I got this. Don't worry.
360, runway 34, clear takeoff.
That was us.
Okay, 360, clear takeoff 34, 37, Mike.
Oh, how was it us?
I turned it off, turn it back on.
87 Juliet Alpha,
it's
yeah,
off,
the
right?
Beach jet is in sight.
It's not doing it.
87 Juliet Alpha, thanks. Follow the beach jet on the downwind.
One moment, please. I have need to.
We'll follow the beach craft on the downwind. 87 Juliet Alpha.
Our flaps are up, a car piece on. Transponder on standby. I actually get that damn thing off. Blue sprayed, radio electricals off.